Welcome back to 5 Minute Histories. Today we're setting sail on the high seas of history as we dive into the captivating story of Ottoman naval power and the legendary Battle of Lepanto. Join us as we uncover the secrets of the Mediterranean and the pivotal clash that reshaped the course of maritime history. Let's start our journey by casting our gaze upon the shimmering waters of the Mediterranean, where the Ottoman Empire emerged as a formidable naval force in the 16th century. Picture this: mighty galleys adorned with billowing sails aimed to the teeth with cannons and warriors. This was the Ottoman Navy, a force to be reckoned with, dominating the seas from Istanbul to North Africa. But how did the Ottomans achieve such maritime might? It all began with Sultan Suleiman the Magnificent, a ruler whose vision extended far beyond the shores of his empire. Recognizing the strategic importance of naval power in securing Ottoman interests and projecting imperial authority, Suleiman embarked on an ambitious campaign to strengthen the Ottoman navy. Under his enlightened rule, the Ottoman navy underwent a profound transformation propelled by a relentless pursuit of innovation and technological advancement. Suleiman spared no expense in modernizing the fleet, commissioning sleek warships armed with the latest naval weaponry and outfitted with state-of-the-art technology. From the formidable firepower of its cannons to the agility of its vessels, every aspect of the Ottoman navy was meticulously engineered to ensure dominance on the high seas. But Suleiman's naval reforms went beyond mere hardware. Recognizing that the strength of a navy lay not only in its ships, but also in the skill and discipline of its sailors, he implemented rigorous training programs and instituted strict discipline within the ranks. The result was a force that was not only technologically superior, but also highly proficient in the art of naval warfare. As a testament to Suleiman's vision and leadership, the Ottoman Navy emerged from this period of reform as one of the most formidable maritime powers in the world, capable of projecting Ottoman power across the vast expanse of the Mediterranean and beyond. The Mediterranean, the cradle of civilization and the stage upon which empires rise and fall. For the Ottomans, mastery of these shimmering waters was not merely a matter of economic gain or territorial expansion, it was a symbol of their imperial prestige and a manifestation of their enduring power. From the bustling ports of Constantinople to the bustling markets of Cairo, every city along the Mediterranean coast was a vital artery of the Ottoman Empire, pulsating with the lifeblood of trade and commerce. The sea itself served as a vast highway connecting the far reaches of the empire, facilitating the flow of goods, people, and ideas across continents and cultures. But the Mediterranean was more than just a conduit for wealth and prosperity. It was also a theater of power and influence, where rival empires vied for supremacy and nations clashed in the pursuit of their ambitions. Here, control over the seas meant control over the trade routes, strategic choke points, and the fates of nations. And it was the Ottoman Navy that stood as the guardian of its maritime empire, ensuring the security of its coastlines and the integrity of its borders with unwavering vigilance. But the calm seas of the Ottoman dominance were soon to be shattered by the tempest of war. Enter the Battle of Lepanto, a clash of titans that would echo through the ages. In 1571, off the coast of Greece, near the Gulf of Patras, the Ottoman Navy faced off against an alliance of European powers in a showdown that would determine the fate of the Mediterranean. This monumental battle involved the Holy League, a coalition formed by Pope Pius V, consisting of Spain, Venice, and several other Italian states, each vested in curbing the Ottoman expansion and preserving Christian dominion over the seas. Picture the scene: hundreds of ships locked in a deadly dance, cannons roaring, swords clashing, and the fate of the empires hanging in the balance. Amidst the violent turmoil of the battle, galleys adorned with banners representing their realms maneuvered through the chaos, with soldiers and sailors caught in the brutal reality of naval warfare. The Ottomans, led by the capable Admiral Ali Pasha, fought with unwavering determination and skill. Yet despite their valiant efforts and tactical prowess, they were ultimately outmatched by the strategic ingenuity and sheer firepower of the Holy League, commanded by Don Juan of Austria. The result was cataclysmic for the Ottomans, who suffered tremendous losses both in terms of fleet and manpower. The battle did not just inflict a physical defeat, it marked a significant psychological blow, signaling a shift in naval power and heralding a period where European navies began to challenge and eventually supersede Ottoman dominance in the Mediterranean. The reverberations of this defeat were felt deeply within the Ottoman Empire, shaking the foundations of their maritime supremacy and altering the naval balance in the Mediterranean for decades to come. For the Ottomans, Lepanto was a wake-up call, a reminder that even the mightiest empires could be brought to its knees by the winds of fortune. It spurred them to redouble their efforts and modernize their navy and adapt to changing times. And for Europe, Lepanto was a moment of triumph, a shining example of what could be achieved when nations set aside their differences and united against a common foe. And so, viewers, we come to the end of our journey through the Ottoman naval power and the Battle of Lepanto. It's a tale of courage, conquest, triumph, and tragedy. Join us next time as we set sail on another adventure through the currents of history.